All right, so I thought I'd make two short videos about my new book. This first paper copy just came in the mail. Very exciting for me. You can kind of see how thick it is, how it feels in your hands. SQL for Data Scientists, a beginner's guide for building datasets for analysis by me, Renee T. So the first video I wanted to kind of go through what's in the book and who it's for. And then the second video, I'll kind of give an example of how you can use it as a learner. So let's start with the table of contents. So that it's got a quick table of contents here, which you can see on my website, sqlfordatascientists.com. And then there's a more detailed table of contents. So I'll kind of breeze through this. Basically, I go into a little bit about databases and data sources that you might be querying from. Very basic SQL intro, select statement, where clause, which is for filtering the results, case statements, which are like if statements, joins, where you might want to take multiple tables from the database and combine them together, aggregation, group bys, min max, counting, averaging, things like that, window functions, which is maybe a little more advanced than you might expect from a beginner's book, but it's something commonly used by data scientists. So I try to focus on the types of SQL that data analysts and data scientists use. Date and time functions, yeah, we use that all the time. So I've got lots about that. Exploratory data analysis, EDA. You can do this both on the raw database to find out what's in there, and then after you combine your all the data sources and aggregation and everything into a data set, you can also use EDA to explore the relationship between the different fields and whatever you're trying to predict for the predictive modeling piece. But that's about exploring the raw tables. Starting to build data sets for reporting. So up until this point, it's all basic SQL, very introductory. It's meant for beginners. Then we start talking about how are you going to use these techniques to build a data set for reporting. We go into some other query structures like unions, self-joins, creating machine learning data sets. So here I talk about if you're going to build a time series model or a binary classification model. We don't actually get into building the models. We're talking about building the data sets that will be used for inputs into the models. Analytical data set development with examples. So here we get into more practical, like why would I take a certain approach if I were asked to answer a question? How do I answer that with the data from the database? Creating tables and views to store the data. And then you've got, there's exercises at the end of every single chapter. So it kind of tests your knowledge of whether you gained from that chapter what I hoped you would, and there's answers in the back for all of those exercises. So here in the introduction, you get into who I am, why I'm writing about this, and I wanted to focus on this part because I think this is a lot of the questions that you all have had have been related to this in terms of, is this book for me? So I'm just going to read this to you. SQL for Data Scientists is designed to be a learning resource for anyone who wants to become or who already is a data analyst or data scientist, and who wants to be able to pull data from the databases to build their own data sets without having to rely on others in the organization to query the source system and transform it into flat files or spreadsheets for them. So this is like when you work at a company and you have to rely on data engineers and describe what you need and get into all the details and hope they understand what you want and build it and go back and forth. The whole point of this is to let you do that yourself. So there are plenty of SQL books out there, but many are either written as syntax references or written for people in other roles like DBAs that create, query from, and maintain databases. However, this book is written from the perspective of a data scientist and aimed at those who will primarily be extracting data from existing databases in order to generate data sets for analysis. So I'm pulling from my own experience here. I won't assume that you've ever written SQL queries before, and we'll start with the basics, but I do assume that you've had some basic understanding of what databases are and a general idea of how data might be used in reports, analyses, and machine learning algorithms. So you don't have to know how to do all this stuff, just kind of know the concepts, right? This book is meant to fill in the steps between finding a database that contains the data you need and starting the analysis. I aim to teach you how to think about structuring data sets for analysis and how to use SQL to extract the data from the database and get it into that form. So I go a little bit into why I think you should learn SQL. I think this whole chapter might be available on the Wiley website. I'll link to it if so. But if not, you can pause the video and read it here. What I hope you gain from this book. So my goal is that by the time you finish reading this book and practicing the queries within, and ideally you'll practice on both the example database that I provide, which I'll show in the second video, and on another database of your choosing. So you have to modify the example queries and apply them in another context. So if you have access to another database, you can write the same kind of queries against a totally different source. That you'll be able to think through the process of creating an analytical data set and develop the SQL code necessary to generate your intended output. I hope that even if you end up needing to use a SQL function that's not covered in this book, you have gained enough baseline knowledge from the book to go look it up online and determine how to best use it in the query you're developing. I also hope that this book will help you feel confident that you can pull your own data at work and get it into the form you needed in for your report or model without having to wait on others to do it for you. All right, so chapter 1 just kind of talks about data sources, but in the next video, I'm going to skip to chapter 2, which actually gets into writing queries, and show you how you can use this book along with the companion website to actually learn and practice SQL.